The IT department has a dirty little secret I'm going to let you in on. But first, let me ask you, what do they always tell you never to do with your password? I'm going to bet the first thing they say is, don't write it down. And number two, don't share it. Because if you share it, well, then we don't know who's actually logged in. Now, the dirty little secret. What do you think they do with their most sensitive accounts, the thing we call privileged accounts, like root and sysadmin and database administrators and things like that? Here's the dirty little secret. They share them. Not every organization, but a lot do. They have a different use case that they're trying to deal with. So in your case, you're one person here, and you are logging into maybe a couple of different systems. And so you have your password, and you should keep that in your head, and you should not share it. And you log in, and that's that. Well, in their case, they've got lots of users. Maybe they've got, in this fictitious example, 5 privileged users that need to log into maybe 100 of these different servers. So now, if they have unique passwords, that would be 500 passwords that they have to keep up with and manage. That's a problem. So instead of having this where they log in separately with separate unique passwords, they set one password to all of them, they share it amongst the privileged users, and they tell them don't tell it to anybody. But the fact is they're sharing. Well, now we know intuitively that that is the wrong thing to do. This advice they gave you is the right advice. They're just not following it. And the reason they're not following it is because of this. Now, what could they do that would be better? I'll suggest to you a better solution would be to have your administrators logging in not directly to these systems with their passwords, but in fact, we'll insert a layer in between. We'll call it PAM, Privileged Access Management System. And what the PAM system does is it says these users up here log directly into the PAM system, and they'll use something like that I talked about in a previous video, multi-factor authentication. So not just a password, and in fact, maybe not a password at all, but we would use something you have, like a phone or something like that that's pre-registered, something you are, like a biometric, looking at your face. So we'll use some form of strong multi-factor authentication to know that this privileged user is who they claim to be. Then this system will maintain the passwords that are unique and constantly changing to all of the systems they need to log into. So they check out the password, the credentials to log into a system. They don't even need to know what they are. They do their work, and when they're done, they check the account back in. And once that's done, the password is literally changed. So they can't even use that same password over again. There's no reuse and therefore no sharing that's going on in this case. Now we always know which one of the 5 people was logged onto this system at a particular point in time. And in a good PAM system, we'll also add a surveillance, an oversight layer as well. And in that, we'll actually see all the things that those users type during their session. It's a digital monitoring and playback type system. And once we have that level of oversight, now we have a much stronger solution. So if the IT department will follow their own advice and not share passwords and use a PAM system, they can get a much stronger security solution that's actually easier for their end users, their privileged users, because now they have a solution that gets multi-factor, gets them in, it's more secure, it's easier, and we have the monitoring and oversight to ensure that it's in fact, a better solution all the way around. Thanks for watching. Please remember to like this video and subscribe to this channel so we can continue to bring you content that matters to you.